My name is Wang Tuo. I'm in Beijing. My hometown is in northeast part of China. Changchun is the capital city of Jilin Province. So I've been staying there for the past year. The solo exhibition I'm having right now at UCCA Beijing. So it's sort of my first institutional survey in China. And there are like eight pieces of my recent works. And one of them is quite an important series. It's called the Northeast Tetralogy. This entire project is about how I see the entire Northeast and also how I see the entire China, the Chinese reality. The title, Empty Handed into History, actually. I think that's how I feel about like a dive into the entire history, the modern history of China. And history is one of the main subject matters in my practice. Actually, I have two topics or two main narrative I think I cannot escape from. One of them is the shamanism because I'm Manchurian, and in the northeast part of China, the shamanism is a big thing there. So shamanism to me is a perspective of how you view history. It's like a how a human being becomes a medium of seeing through different time and space. So basically, there's no real shaman at all appears in my films. No, there's no real shaman, but you can see a lot of singing and dancing. So basically, that type of thing could be changed into something like a ritual. And that ritual could give you some experience of traveling to different time and space. A lot of people ask me if my work process is like a director. Actually, it's not. So the entire process, actually, I feel like myself is like a writer. I'm writing a novel. In a lot of cases, I have to write a story by myself, and there's it has to go along with my own narrative and my own perspective of how I see the a particular moment of history. So, for instance, like in the film Tangles, the peach blossom spring, actually, that was a very classic, famous Chinese folklore. I borrowed like first half of it, and I changed the latter part of it, into another story. And I think one, especially for the Chinese audience, when they encounter this film and they encounter this narrative of the peach blossom spring, and they'll say, "Okay, I know this story because this one is so famous." But when they finish the entire narrative, they will be shocked because it's another story totally.
Omoniga. 아들 보고 말하기를 몇년 전에 고기 잡으러 갔다가 돌아오지 않아서 옆집 사람 들르고 도처에 찾아다녔어. 어머니가 말하기를 얼마 후에 그 냇가의 끝에서 그 오래된 무덤에서 너희 배의 잔액을 봤거든. 사람들은 다 네가 이 세상을 떠났다 하더라. 그러나 이 밑에 동안에 나는 네가 꼭 돌아오리라 믿으면서 예전처럼 저녁밥을 할 때마다 이 방울을 울리면서 창밖을 내다보았어.
I did wrote a lot of ghost stories, and yeah, I think ghosts narrative in China, actually, that's quite fascinating. And I often use the ghost as a metaphor or a parallel narrative for the archives or history. And in China, normally we have we will keep that person's seat, you know, when we have a dinner together at a round table, we will still have his seat, and we will have a bowl of rice. We will pour a cup of wine for him. But that is a vacuum. That is an empty space. But the empty space, or we can say, is something like a narrative space, negative space. You can see nothing, but you can see the chair, you can see the table, you can see the chopsticks and the bowl of rice. The emptiness is how we believe that person we love is still with us. So the empty space is the ghost itself. So it's very much like the how the archive, history archives exist in China. A lot of time we cannot see some particular archives, and we cannot say anything about some particular moments of history. So it's like it's hidden. But we can see the objects around that emptiness. So basically, history and the ghost, they're like the same thing.
我出自酒席，也出自米勒。人因私事而起居，何炅以冻伤。才有了单膝累孽，因我在轮回之中，忘了这故去，也忘了这未来。等待时空中的一心交汇，来需要我接近的这点缺液，重复我最后的动作。